Welcome to the PRU-ICSSG Cores, IOs, and Peripherals Training Module. During this module, we will be discussing the PRU-ICSSG processing cores and their clocking options. We will also look at the different IO modes and integrated peripherals available within the PRU-ICSSG. The PRU-ICSSG is the next generation subsystem to the PRU-ICSS, building on the features and capabilities of the PRU-ICSS. As such, this module assumes that you have some familiarity with the PRU-ICSS and will focus primarily on new or upgraded features within the PRU-ICSSG. At the heart of the PRU-ICSSG are four 32-bit RISC cores. These RISC cores include two Programmable Real-Time Units, or PRUs, and two Auxiliary Programmable Real-Time Units, or RTU PRUs. During this training, we will be verbally referring to the RTU PRUs as simply RTUs. As you might remember, the original PRU-ICSS had two PRU cores and no RTU cores. This enhancement allows the PRU-ICSSG to have additional processing power and flexibility. On the PRU-ICSSG, the PRU and RTUs are comprised of the same RISC core. They just have different resources, connections, and accelerators. For example, the RTUs don't have access to any external general purpose inputs or general purpose output pins. Given this, the RTUs are strictly available for data processing, while the PRUs can be used for I/O control and/or data processing. Additionally, the RTUs typically have smaller instruction RAM compared to the PRU cores and have access to different accelerators. One thing that the PRU and RTUs have in common is that they both have access to all shared PRU-ICSSG resources and SoC resources. Each PRU or RTU can also operate either 1. Independently or 2. In coordination with the ARM or the other PRU or RTU cores. This allows each PRU and RTU to be used for a different task or for the cores to be used in tandem for more advanced tasks. Additionally, all four PRU-ICSSG cores can run at a max clock speed of 250 MHz. The default speed, however, is 200 MHz, similar to the original PRU-ICSS. The PRU-ICSSG's core VBUS sync N bitfield enables the high-speed 250 MHz mode, as well as a new sync mode. This sync mode allows the PRU and RTU core clocks to be in lockstep with the SoC interconnect. This mode should be used by applications requiring the lowest latency when accessing SoC resources outside of the PRU-ICSSG. Let's next look at the PRU-ICSSG IOs, which, as we already discussed, are only available on the PRU cores. The PRU-ICSSG has all the same IO modes as the previous PRU-ICSS, just with some enhancements. The basic IO modes include a direct output and input mode for simple bit bang operations, a shift out and shift in serializer option, and a parallel capture input. Additionally, there are peripheral interface serializers for NDAT or other general purpose applications and a 9-channel sigma delta. While the PRU-ICSS and PRU-ICSSG support a variety of modes, it's important to realize that each PRU core can only be configured for one input and one output mode at a given time. Let's now discuss the PRU-ICSSG specific upgrades. In direct output mode, we added an optional bidirectional support. In the past, the GP outputs and GP inputs were unidirectional. Oftentimes, they were muxed on the same pin, and the SoC would need to select which mux mode the PRU IO was operating in, either input or output. This configuration still exists on PRU-ICSSG. However, the PRU GP outputs now support a new optional bidirectional mode. This mode option requires that the device pinmuxing be set for GP output mode and the bidirectional functionality be enabled in the device level control MMRs. The I/O direction can then be controlled by the PRU-ICSSG's DigIO data out enable register within the IEP peripheral. This bidirectional mode allows the PRU firmware to easily change the I/O direction with low latency. The PRU-ICSSG's shift in and shift out I/O modes add new configuration options to provide greater flexibility. For example, there are now options to select a 0 or 1 start bit when operating in shift in mode, or to output a free running clock when in shift out mode. Lastly, the Sigma Delta has several enhancements. These include increasing the counter size to achieve greater precision and also adding a fast detect logic to monitor the minimum and maximum ones in a 32-bit sliding window. Similar to PRU-ICSS, PRU-ICSSG has several integrated peripherals. By integrating the peripherals inside of the ICSS subsystem, the PRU read and write access latency is significantly reduced compared to external SoC level peripherals. The PRU-ICSSG peripherals include UART, ECAP, Industrial Ethernet Peripheral or IEP, PWM, MDIO, and MIIGRT. As shown in the table on this slide, some of the peripherals are identical to PRU-ICSS, others are upgraded, and one is brand new. Let's now talk about each of the peripherals in more detail. The UART and ECAP peripherals on PRU-ICSSG are identical to the previous PRU-ICSS. The UART can run up to 12 megabits per second, and the ECAP can operate in either an enhanced capture or auxiliary PWM mode. The Industrial Ethernet Peripheral, or IEP, supports the same basic functionalities as the PRU-ICSS. There's a timer with compare and capture capabilities, sync signals, watchdog timers, and digital IOs. Whereas the PRU-ICSS only has one IEP instance, the PRU-ICSSG adds a second IEP instance. There's also two additional modes enabled within the IEP timer. A slave mode, which allows one IEP instance to act as a slave to the other, and shadow mode, which configures the master IEP counter for either 64-bit or 32-bit mode. A new peripheral to PRU-ICSSG is the PWM, which can be used for motor control applications. This PWM peripheral is different from the device-level PWM peripheral. It supports up to four sets of three-phased motor control with 12 primary and 12 complementary programmable PWM outputs and has very flexible trip generation. Slide 6, PRU-ICSSG peripherals. Both the MIIGRT and MDIO are upgraded peripherals on the PRU-ICSSG. The MIIGRT peripheral now enables gigabit Ethernet speeds and supports MII, RGMII, and SGMII functionality. The MDIO peripheral also adds Clause 22 and Clause 45 support. There are also several additional upgrades for both of these peripherals, as shown on this slide. This concludes the training module on the PRU-ICSSG cores, IOs, and peripherals. For more information and to get started with the PRU-ICSSG, visit the link shown on this slide. For PRU-ICSSG support, visit the E2E forums.